and girls of every age. Wouldn't you like to see something strange?
Come with us and you will see. This is our town of Halloween.
This is Halloween. This is Halloween.
Pumpkins scream in the dead of night.
This is Halloween. Everybody make a scene.
Trick or treat.
Tell the neighbors on your diaphragm.
It's our town.
Everybody's free.
This town of Halloween.
I am the one hiding under your bed. Teeth ground sharp and eyes glowing red.
I am the one hiding under your stairs. Fingers like snakes and spiders in my hair.
This is Halloween. This is Halloween. Halloween, 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 Halloween.
Hey everybody, Didum Har logging in today, and I'm back with my beautiful wife Mifa in the quarry, and it is your turn for Emma, and let's hope, let's try reading that fortune we got from the tarot card, see if we can interpret it a bit better. So when you get the chance, pause it and we'll take a look.
Okay, here's a riddle for you. What's got two thumbs and...
Let's see, so we did the star.
Is this the one that you're talking about?
Yep.
Oh, it's the star. Stars in the night sky, beacons of light, dreams of hope, purpose, or a reminder of our insignificant sphere of despair. Trust in the light of the star, with it comes clarity and sometimes proof.
It's Quarry, we can replay the vision. Okay, looks... Oh!
She's taking a picture?
Of the thing.
So we're going to... Okay, first of all, I'm going to go up against this fucking thing again, and I have to take a picture of it. Right? Or is it saying not to take a picture? But it says clarity. It says proof.
Proof. Sometimes proof.
So is she going to get proof of the thing?
Yeah.
That's... Okay.
That might be it, but they'll... I fucking don't...
We'll see what...
Yeah.
It brings, I
suddenly
guess.
Riding solo on a freaky island in the dark. This fool. Well, one thumb. One available thumb. Okay. And it was here, on a strange, uninhabited island, that this brave young soul found herself.
Okay, yeah, full moon.
We get
okay,
that.
Full disclosure, I've suddenly found myself on a strange, tiny little island, all alone with nothing to do but show you guys around. So, there's a treehouse over there. I'm gonna go and see if I can't dish out some of that sweet, sweet panoramic goodness. Because here's the thing. Not that I want to go back, because I don't. But even if I did, I can't. Because then I'd look like the super needy one when he was the one who stormed off in the first place. God, you know what? Sorry, I'm bending. Explore venting. You know what? Fuck it. Let's do it. To the treehouse, fellow explorers!
I mean, she has a light on it and everything.
Okay, so this... Okay, the right... Okay.
No prizes for guessing what these are. Can't say that I've used them. A little too au naturel for me, TVH. You know... I've never thought about where the waist goes.
Don't.
Oh. Well, please, God, no. Okay. We're gonna just go ahead and ignore that. Yeah.
We're just gonna ignore that, yes. I'm just trying to...
And there's no cave.
Just in case there's something. Ah, I hate.
Yeah, that's the downside of walking too close to walls and shit with this kind of game.
Okay, I can't see where I'm going now.
The camera does not want to help work with you.
So this island is like an unexcavated part of the quarry that rewilded itself after it flooded into the lake. Pretty cool, huh? You know, when I was little, I used to think that islands just kind of would float in the middle of the water, kind of like an airbed. But I'm older and wiser now, and realize that not everything's always as it seems. Kind of like how you thought you were just having a hot summer fling, and then it turns into babysitting a big hairy man-child who's all sad because you don't want to go steady with him and write him love letters every freaking day. And while we're talking about it, you don't mind that we're talking about it, right? Why is it up to me to justify my feelings when he's the one who got all bluh about it, you know? Oh, look. The metaphor in the narrative, by mean of fork in the road. How fitting. Here's the big question. Do I take the high road, literally, and forget about it? Or do I continue on the path I'm on and keep ranting about my stupid dumb life? I guess since this isn't live, the choice is up to me.
I hate how I heard that sound.
Wait, first of all, I thought I saw something over here.
You did.
And this is the meeting shelter. It's a shelter where you meet at.
Jesus.
Okay, I'm trying really hard to make this interesting, but sometimes a thing just is what it is. I think I've made my point.
Alright. So, what do you want to do, honey? Do you want to go?
I thought there would be more. Like a tarot card or something.
Might be. Like she said, keep walking down the path and ranting about her life, or go upstairs and forget about it.
Oh, what the hell. We're in it now anyway. Well and truly in the thick of it.
Well, I guess I'm going this way.
Because you know what else? I was really excited for the next part of my life, you know? I mean, the summer was great, but what's next? I mean, come on!
And I can come back.
I know by the time I post this, Hackett's Quarry will just be but a distant memory, and I know it's just one night, and you have to make the most of all your opportunities, and yada yada yada. I guess I just don't want to have to settle for what's around me, you know? Abby sees me as this confident person, but really? I'm just desperate to stay afloat in a world where everyone wants to be different.
How does she still have makeup on when she was in there? Maybe
she Game had... logic.
Well, I mean, there are some waterproof makeup out there. Why did I decide to go on a creepy ass trail? What is wrong with me?
Into the unknown.
There's like nothing here.
So far from what we can see. And she's not ranting and raving anymore, so.
This is actually kind of fun. I feel like this is the first time I've been alone all summer. Kind of like it. I guess that kind of reinforces the whole Jacob thing. I know the plan was for him to come get me, but now that I'm by myself, I kind of like it. Sorry, Jacob, if you're watching. Nothing personal. It's a me thing. We're cool, right? Yeah, we're cool.
Are you, though? Be aggressive or reflective?
I mean, who knows? Maybe in 50 years we'll bump into each other and be flooded with fond memories of that one amazing summer at Hackett's Quarry summer camp.
That spark
that changed our lives forever. Then we'll be like 7-year-old lovers or whatever and have crazy walker sex. Hey, it could happen.
Yeah, I think that's our hand.
Only time will tell, Jakey boy, and as they say,
I don't know, freaking me out for a second. Okay, things are freaking me out.
But we will be the oldest, sexiest fools there ever were. Until then, I gotta do my thing. Sorry, buddy.
Jesus. Really don't like Emma.
Oh, and there's a wall.
Oh.
Thinking about it, how could this have been Mr. H when he was back at the lodge?
Quoth
the raven nevermore.
Damn it, no! Why? Bloated corpse.
What am I looking at? What was it? What did it say that was?
It was like a box of matches. There it is. Oh.
Where am I on here? Oh, there's an arrow.
From the harbinger. Fucking motel!
This is the goddamn Harbinger Motel! Every time I see that, I just remember the guy saying that. Is this
the there's a ladder.
God, I'm stuck. Alright, there's a ladder, but I'm scared. Do you think we can go back?
I don't think so, as far as I know.
Oh, okay. I guess I'll go up the ladder.
Guess I gotta do this one-handed, huh?
Or not?
That didn't sound great.
Well, she's gonna die. Oh, I'm scared.
Why?
Oh my god.
Just thought you should know.
What if
I am nailing this ladder climbing?
What if I didn't?
All right. This is the luxurious Skyway Treehouse, obviously. Constructed in the year 1805 by a blindfolded man who used only the finest rotting wood, rusty nails, and donkey spit that money could buy. A real vintage classic.
Oh god, that was
Honey,
great.
I'm home. What's that now? I forgot the children's bedtime. Well now, that's a fine how do you do. Take it all in, folks. That's the summer camp experience right there, and oh look. It seems somebody forgot to clear the place out.
It was a little poor limb sinking
in
there.
Stuff, or maybe one of the guys back there? But I don't recognize this.
Oh, hell no. Oh, hell no.
Looks like we have a choice on our hands. Do we snoop through someone else's belongings? Or do we open the spooky trapdoor and die a horrible, painful death?
Don't even joke about that.
I'd rather snoop in someone's fucking thing.
Bag it is. And you know what? I'm putting some clothes on.
Okay,
this
I think
that's
right.
All you're getting.
She had clothes on in the vision. Or it could be a bad choice. We don't know now.
Yeah.
But I'd rather snoop in someone's belongings than open that fucking trap door. What?
Did that look like a fucking rogue robed figure on the top of that fucking...
Yeah, it did. But I thought it was something else. Oh! Taser!
Armed and dangerous!
I'm tasing something!
Okay, so... I think there's something up there.
Oh! She's
and
gonna fucking...
Not
okay,
gonna make
well,
me jump.
I'm glad
I
put
that
clothes
much.
On first for this.
Good thing you have clothes and a taser.
Yeah, so I'm tasing some shit. The moment it says...
Goodbye,
taste,
cool world! The
run,
final curtain
I'm
is
tasing.
Calling and there's no time for an encore.
No!
Oh! Come the fuck on! Oh god, man. This wasn't how the vision went, but. Let's go. Where is that fuck? Oh, you bitch!
Spray!
Yeah! Good work, Mipha. You're giving yourself quite the head start in this shit.
Oh, almost did a different way.
gotta get out of that fucking treehouse. It's definitely a good thing we got. Oh, fuck. Block door or use
trap door because there's a big ass window right there. It can still.
That's not gonna hold it. Come on, be realistic.
So you wanted me to be Emma. What's next?
Dylan!
Dylan, you're the only one I really want to keep alive. Please don't make me do this. What's going on? Okay, let's see what this...
They get to the lodge just
I
good.
He's okay.
Are you in pain?
No, sorry. I'm really hungry.
Oh,
I'll get
yeah?
you some food inside.
Really
okay?
hungry? For what? I'm just kidding.
I swear to God, if he starts vomiting out normal food, I'm going to be very concerned.
Oh, man. I can eat a horse.
Well, I don't know if we'll be able to find you a horse, but maybe some granola?
Oh, yuck, I hate granola.
You can walk?
You got it.
I was like, bitch, you better.
That caught me off guard. I wasn't expecting it to pop up in a cutscene, but good to
strength.
Know. Yep. Strength. Strength can be surprising, knowing one's own raw power, tapping into a previously unknown energy. I suppose there are forces at work within us all, and with one hand it gives in, with the other it could rip away. I have a feeling this is a tarot card for Nick.
There's a lot more places than I would think.
It's a big place.
A blurry close-up photo of Emma being attacked at the treehouse. Oh, it has an exclamation. The body in the lake looks like it could be one of those missing hikers. Someone was clearly trying to hide it.
Ha! Fucking knew it.
So, since Jacob went down there,
we do learn that.
We were able to learn more.
Yep.
Oh, we didn't get that one. Okay.
Nope.
Hackett history.
Yes.
Box of matches. Is this someone? I'm gonna keep saying that. I don't know why. It just makes me. Oh, let's see this. Above the law.
Finders keepers. Distraction.
Alright.
This will open the nurse's station. Should be plenty of stuff in there.
Well, hopefully we can just get him cleaned up for now.
I'll get you something to eat.
You dumbasses should have had your party in here.
You and
like
I
you
are
were told.
Find a landline.
Oh, yeah. Isn't there one in Mr. H's office?
Yep. We'll come meet you.
Copy that.
And we know about the freaking heat secret passage, too.
I really hope they're gonna be okay. Do you think that whatever's left in the nurse's office is gonna cut it?
Caitlin knows what she's doing.
Does she? I mean, she wasn't even supposed to be working at the nurse's office this summer. She only filled in because some other girl didn't show up.
It's better than nothing. Come on,
Laura,
let's go call for backup.
Yep.
It's pretty weird to see this place so dead.
You never came down here?
Shut the goddamn doors!
What? No,
what?
A couple times.
Why are the doors
yeah.
not open?
Like they know something's out there.
Oh, I don't know. Close the door.
Where are you going?
I thought I just heard my name.
I didn't hear anything.
Dylan, close the door. Brian, close the door.
Seriously, they know something's out there. They also know people are out there, thanks to Jacob. So it's like, what the fuck?
Well, that's good news.
Yeah.
So what now?
We got a call for help. Who should I call?
Mr. H?
The only number I got is to this phone.
Okay, then 911.
You mean 911? Who says 911?
I don't know.
Anyway, yeah, but like, what should I ask for? Like, police? Ambulance?
Huh.
What should we? The cops?
Cops. With guns. We need a lot of backup out here.
So, they'll say, 911, what's your emergency? And then I say, help, my friends may have been attacked by a bear, or maybe not a bear, but definitely an animal with teeth, and we're not sure how many there are out there or how smart they are, so it's very possible they might be mounting an attack on us right now, and we really need backup.
Okay, I get it.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
I would have just gone for the ambulance, maybe some officers.
911.
What's wrong?
Dead.
Well, that's weird.
Phones go dead sometimes out here.
Right when you're about to call the cops, though?
It's a coincidence.
Did you try the hang-up thingy?
What?
Here.
What are you doing?
I don't know. It's what they do in movies when the phone goes dead. You tap on the little thingy.
We're not in a movie.
Okay.
That you know of.
How do you know that? Maybe this is what they want you to think, man.
Oh my god. Dylan's that one guy from, like, the cabin in the woods.
No one has signal. Is there anywhere else in the camp that has a landline?
Well, not a landline.
What?
The radio hut has some old broadcast gear.
Where you do your announcements?
Where I curate my sweet summer jams, yeah, and where I do the PA announcements. It has some old equipment there. I think we could probably break something up and get a message out.
Nice.
All right, yeah. Let's head over there and see if we can contact somebody. Put that back, Dylan.
I will put it back when we're good and safe and help is on the way.
Okay, just careful with it.
I'll be fine. Okay.
It's probably the weather.
What weather?
Clear fucking sky, Ryan.
Maybe it was the bears.
Bear. And why does everyone blame everything on bears? Okay. So for the sake of argument, what if that bear that cut our phone line and just cut out all the power? What if that bear is waiting for us out in the hallway?
Fair point.
Thank you.
We should probably tell Caitlin that we're going to the radio hut. They're probably freaked.
Yeah, okay, yeah, let's go.
And leave them a gun. We have two now. Separate that shit.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Yeah.
Leave that to Caitlin.
Good call.
Do you think she really needs it, though?
She needs it just as much as we do.
She's staying in the lodge. We're going out there.
You literally just said there might be something dangerous in the lodge.
When?
Like 20 seconds ago.
Okay, sure. But That's because I really wanted the gun.
Just give her the gun, man.
All right. You're right.
I think they need a gun, too.
Yeah.
Still have mine. If you're extra nice to me, I might let you hold it.
Don't write a check that your ass can't cash.
My ass has got quite the bank account.
Oh my god.
Caitlin, don't tell me what the fuck are you doing?
Am I interrupting something?
Wow. Getting all pissy all of a sudden.
Chin up, big guy. I wouldn't really know what to do with it, okay? I trust you. Oh, thank you so much, Dylan. You're so generous and handsome. Yeah, no problem. Don't mention it.
The hell?
Oh,
Emma!
No,
we're
no.
Back with Emma!
Why? 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 Fuck. So far, Emma's been a bad bitch. Like, she's a badass.
Oh, she's got a way out, though, if she can get to the top. Oh, that's what I was seeing, is that I thought it was like a hooded thing. Be faster than that.
No, why make more noise?
It's making noise now!
No, we're gonna go slow and steady wins the race. Slow and steady wins the race. Nope. Slow and steady wins the race.
I fucking knew!
Or not. Okay. Oh my god!
Oh my god! I like the music is played. It gives you that, like, Amazonian triumph thing. Victory! Gosh, rising up like a bat. Oh, it's...
No, I don't want my taser anymore. No!
I got fried by the water. But hey, we got a good use out of it.
Yeah.
Oh, Jacob's going back to the island. Oh.
Oh, good to see you.
Okay,
good to
for
see
now.
You. That time again, is it?
Yes, it is.
Strength. Strength can be surprising. Knowing one's own raw power, tapping into a previously unknown energy. I suppose. There are forces at work within us all, and with one hand it gives, and with the other it could rip away. As always, there's more to see.
Yep.
And as always, the choice is yours. Would you like to see more?
Yes, because these visions have been helpful so far. Let's keep it going. With strength, unnatural strength.
Goodbye again. I'll leave you with this. Remember who your friends are. Remember who's looking out for you.
But she says that a lot to us. Remember who your friends are. Mm-hmm. I'm your friend. You said so yourself.
Yeah.
Like, are you our friend? Are you sure? Like.
Yeah, seriously. But she did make a very good point. Remember who your friends are and remember who's looking out for you. Yep. Or he might have let him go. I don't know. White noise.
Chapter 5.
Yep.
White noise. I keep forgetting we see the lady at the end of the chapters.
All right, Nick. How you doing?
Hey, I couldn't find anything to eat. The kitchen's pretty cleaned out. Oh, shoot. I left my bag. I brought you this.
She left her bag.
That was... Fuck. I don't even know what happened. It was all just a blur.
How are you feeling?
Let's be compassionate.
How are you holding up?
I'm just happy you're okay. Are you okay? I'm sorry, I just asked you that.
It's okay.
All right, they're off to find a radio or something.
What's with the,
we found another in Mr. H's office, so just in case.
What happened to the lights?
Not sure. Any better?
I'm doing okay. Kinda.
Wait, are they going to the radio hut?
Phone's dead. They're gonna try to send out an SOS or something. We're holding down the fort.
Fuck. I'm staying silent.
I thought you said Dylan and Ryan already left.
Stay here. I'll check it out.
Be cautious.
We don't know what's out there. It could be dangerous.
Yeah, that's why I'm gonna check it out.
Yep, here we go.
Caitlin, I feel like it's been ages since we've seen her. Like,
yeah. All right. Why are we checking like there was an issue there? Hey, bothers me. Well, at least we know Caitlin's a badass with a gun.
Yep.
What's with that red box right there? Yeah, who moved the furniture from the stairs? That's awfully fucking convenient.
Oh yeah, what?
Did they do that while they were... Some of them went to go do stuff before the bonfire? What the fuck? Oh, it's Mr. Hunter. I'm not gonna expose myself just yet, but I'm... Don't want to give myself away just yet, right now. Because he does seem to be helpful, but I think he's also... more out for himself than anything else. Okay.
No sign of them.
When you find them, blood them. And keep me posted, Bobby.
Blood them.
Blood them.
Oh, what he did to Jacob. But the way she's taking it, if she gets caught right now, it could escalate. So I'm just going to still remain stealthy.
Mm-hmm. How does he not see?
Because the darkness, and he's not adjusting to the dark. Well, he's not even shining his flashlight, which was dumb of him. He could have easily shined his light. Oh, I went too soon.
Oh, fuck.
Where the hell are you, Bobby?
She lost the gun?
I probably went too soon. I should have waited longer. So, definitely have to be... Okay. Back again!
Hey, so this may not be like the best time per se, but like
yeah.
What? Watching this like a movie.
Yeah, so like I was just, you know, thinking about like the start of summer and like now that summer's over and you know, is that like the last time we're gonna see each other, you know?
Sorry, Nick, what are you saying?
She's like, bro, I cannot think about these kind of things.
Confident. Insecure. I want. Be confident.
Hey, don't worry about Caitlin. She's tough.
I know. I'm sorry, Nick. I'm just distracted. Just get through the night, okay?
Okay. I thought things would go further. Better.
Maybe I was misreading the situation back there, but... kind of felt like a little bit more was gonna happen.
Nick, now's not the time.
Well, did you want a little bit more to happen?
Duh, are you dumb?
Hey.
Sorry. I just mean... of course I wanted it to happen, I just... didn't know if
you're getting a bit more
that
assertive.
Seems like such a long time ago now.
Yeah.
You did want it to happen, though. You can tell me.
Yeah, I guess.
Huh. Just saying that because I'm hurt.
Oh my God.
Nick. What is going on out there, Caitlin? We've died. We've died.
It's okay. I got this.
Oh my God.
What happened? Jesus, where's the gun?
We gotta get out. No, we have to hide.
Hide. Because there's only one way out, as far as I know, so...
Is it just me, or is Nick kind of walking okay?
He's walking just fine.
Did he get bit? Right?
He got clawed up. So whatever that vision was supposed to happen, that vision we managed to avoid.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Sorry to ruin your donut.
Wait,
just
one more bite.
Don,
come on.
But I need Ryan time. I'm sorry. Love you, sweetheart. Almost made her spit out the donut.
I hope people can't hear my chewing sound.
Oh, your mic's up here, so they probably won't hear any chewing sound.
I muted my mic, too.
Oh, okay, so never mind. It'll probably be...
I put my mic up there because every time we played together and I down here, my voice was too loud.
Yeah. But so is mine.
Okay. Alright, Dylan. What shit's gonna happen to you this time?
So, the radio hut has, like, an actual radio? I thought it was just, like, for your morning announcements.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It used to be more of a actual radio station, actually. It is still technically, but nobody brings their radio to camp anymore.
Yeah.
It's weird, actually, that there used to be kids with their radio and their portable CD player and everything, and, you know, nowadays, everything we need is on the phone, but Mr. Hackett takes it on the first day of camp so that we're not distracted by technology.
Technology.
Wait, can you just hear a growl?
Give it
yes.
And it. Oh, God.
So is that something, like, that you want to go into?
Camp radio?
No, like, DJing, or music, or something.
Oh, yeah, I mean, I like music,
yay.
But I think I want to major in, quantum physics.
Walking. Quantum physics? That's...
Wait, what?
Yeah.
You don't really seem like a science guy.
Oh, yeah, I mean, you know, not here.
I'm sorry. I'm so completely fascinated by this. What do you mean by not here?
Not here at camp. I do that at home, and then here, I,
You're a wise, cracking smartass?
That's a little harsh, but...
No?
Okay, so maybe I was a little nervous when I arrived in an uncomfortable social situation, and I overcompensated a little bit by making a bunch of jokes.
You played into it.
Yeah, I mean, people kind of enjoyed the blasé Dylan.
And do you enjoy the blasé Dylan?
Not yet, like, you know, whatever, man, it's pretty cool. It's fine. I like Dylan.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Dylan. I'm Ryan. Well, actually, let's get the fuck out of here, Ryan.
Yeah, I like him. That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, let's talk. As much as I like, you know, them talking and being cute and stuff, I saw the thing and we really shouldn't be out here.
She says that as she wanders away from Ryan with the gun.
Who the hell is Jaden?
Probably one of the kids.
Oh, okay.
Shooting stars. That's how many stars they've seen out here? Dude!
Or, you know, like, stars, like...
Yeah, okay, something you can interact with. I was about to say, careful where you step. I wouldn't do that.
Where the hell were you, Ryan? Because you were not the fucking
deer. What is this doing at a kid's summer camp?
I don't know, man. It wasn't here over the summer. I mean, if it was, then we would have noticed that, right?
Whatever it was trying to catch, you can't now.
Yeah, that's so. What did I do?
Yeah, it's gonna be a bummer.
Oh, don't walk that way, damn.
Okay.
I just like looking at these things on TV. Can I, like, interact with it again? Oh, I can look at it. Okay. I guess there's things that I need to explore too. And I'm terrified. Hey, wait. This is the same area that I explored as... Is that bottle still here? Basically,
where they're
super
at.
Super fucking far from everything.
Yep.
I just feel like there's other stuff for me to see before we go to the radio. Oh,
please look up.
What?
Why?
What the hell is that?
That better be meaning. Those lights better mean like there's power over there and nothing ominous. Please.
Oh yeah, he didn't find it too.
Oh, what in the name of voodoo doo-doo is that?
Voodoo doo-doo?
Wonder if that's like a deterrent for those things though, too.
Come on, Dylan. Walk. Learn to walk. I just feel like I'm gonna miss something in this big ass area. What in the hell is this? The letters to Camp Nurse.
That's why Nurse Kelly went home early.
Why? Diane, you can go ahead and take off early today. The bus is going to be a little delayed, and I don't want you waiting around on my account. I'll make sure the kids get home without any bumps or bruises. Thanks for all your help this summer, Chris.
Okay.
So he had her leave early?
Guess so.
I wonder why. He knows something. This bastard knows something. I'm scared. Why can't I go around here?
That's where you came from.
Oh, that's where I came from. Okay. Yeah, I know, Ryan. I know. I'm trying to... It's just so foggy here. I can't see shit. I just don't know where what I've seen and stuff. I feel like there's something else here.
It is a big place.
Okay, you know what? Yes, yeah, so we're just gonna go. I don't need to find anything else. Sorry, you can find it yourself on another place.
Yeah, I have no problem with that. I have no problem with that.
I'm scared out of my fucking mind right now.
I would have that reaction too. On my first run, be like, yep, nope, going straight for the goal. Fuck that clue, going straight for the goal.
Don't get stuck, because if I have to run...
Thankfully, these games don't ever do that to you, because that would suck. Especially with how wonky the controls is and how controls are and how easy it is to get caught. Oh!
I'm really glad that I did.
The Hermit!
Alright, that's all the clues that I'm gonna find. Let's do this. I wanna go inside. Oh, wait, hold on.
Huh.
Something's trying getting it. Oh, tried getting in.
Nothing will come get me as I'm paused. We didn't get anything. Oh. Here we have the hermit. With the hermit comes isolation, loneliness, but reflection. To perhaps given some thought, the hermit who gives chase can guide you to safety, but that all depends on your actions, not his.
Huh.
Alright, Ryan.
All good?
Get the fuck out of here. Yeah, let's just fucking go.
All good?
Oh god, not Ryan, okay.
Let's check the time. We don't say we have 10 minutes, which I don't know if we have.
I don't know. Yeah.
We'll probably end this episode here.
Okay.
Yep, so. Things are definitely getting interesting, and we are learning a bit more, and we going back to the tarot reading for strength. We didn't follow through for the village because we didn't rush in. We didn't run.
We hid.
Yeah, we probably didn't get caught either. That was probably looked like he was going to the window too.
Well, there's two tarot cards, so I guess we missed.
It looks like it.
Oh no, where were they?
I have no idea.
And I'm the one who's been playing, so I totally did not.
It could be somewhere where you were playing as Dylan, or it could have been somewhere where I was playing as Caitlin, because there was. Oh. Actually, no, wait, there wasn't. It was all motion, so. It had to be something with Dylan then. But this is a big ass place.
There's no way in hell I was gonna.
Yeah.
Oh well. We can probably look it up later, so yeah. After this.
So far, that's where Abigail, Caitlin, and Nick are at. And. Camp store. We don't know where. Jacob or Emma are at, apparently, and Dylan and Ryan are here at the radio hut. Yeah, so we don't have eyes on Jacob or Emma.
Yeah.
No, that's not good. I mean, obviously we know Emma's fine.
Well, Emma's somewhere in the forest, yeah. I think.
Well, we know she's fine, she got away.
So is Jacob, I think.
But Jacob is going to the island, that's the problem.
Yeah, I know, I'm just saying that he's probably in the forest.
I actually might have an idea where she's at. Because she was at the treehouse. She ziplined and it went right there. So she's probably going to go somewhere over here.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I don't have a little cursor here to actually show that. Yeah. So I'm showing Mipho exactly where. So, but with that said and done, that is all the time we have for this episode. We'll pick this up next time. So thank you everybody so much for watching. Until next time. This is Dana Mahari and Mipho Mahari signing out.